Hello students, today we are going to start a new chapter of accountancy, chapter number 7. Subject accounts. Name of chapter is dissolution of partnership firm. Dissolution of partnership firm. In this chapter, two separate questions of 3 marks each, comes in board exam. One question is based on journal entries, and another question of 3 marks is based on true, false. Sometimes both questions are based on journal entries also. So you must have theoretical as well as practical knowledge of this chapter. Now in this chapter, first of all try to understand what is the meaning of dissolution. Dissolution means end of existence. End of existence either of partnership firm and second one is partnership. Means definition of dissolution is end of existence either of partnership firm or of partnership is called dissolution of partnership firm. Means end of existence is related with two terms, end of existence of partnership firm or end of existence of partnership. What is the difference between partnership firm and partnership? Partnership is the relation between partners. Partnership is relation between partners. And partnership firm means group of all partners. Partnership indicates relation between or among all partners included in partnership firm, that is called partnership. And partnership firm means group of all partners. So once again, meaning of dissolution, dissolution means end of existence, and end of existence is related with either partnership firm, end of existence of partnership firm, or end of existence of partnership. This is the definition of dissolution. Now, what is the difference between dissolution of partnership firm and dissolution of partnership? Now, first is dissolution of partnership firm. Now, once again, dissolution of partnership firm means end of existence of partnership firm. First point, end of existence of partnership firm. Partnership firm is called dissolution of partnership firm. End of existence of partnership firm is called dissolution of partnership firm. It means in case of dissolution of partnership firm, all partners get separated from the business. Third, in case of dissolution of partnership firm, because whole partnership comes to an end, that's why they need to close their books of accounts. They need to close their books of accounts. They need to close their books of account generally means they need to close all the assets, all the accounts of assets, all types of liabilities. So they need to close the books of accounts, and after closing they need to pay the liabilities by selling the assets. Pay the liabilities. Now, liabilities are of two types on the basis of ownership: internal liabilities, external liabilities. So we'll discuss later on how liabilities are paid, but right now in general form, after closing the books of account, all liabilities are paid. How? By selling the assets. So pay the liabilities after realization means selling the assets and recover the amount. So recovery of amount by selling the asset is called realization. So pay the liabilities after realization of assets. So in this way accounts are settled, and thus accounts are settled and dissolution procedure completed. So whenever a dissolution of partnership firm take place, it means end of existence of partnership firm, or partnership firm comes to an end. This is called dissolution of partnership firm. In case of dissolution of partnership firm, all partners get separated from each other, from the business. Then in case of dissolution of partnership firm, what is the procedure to dissolve the firm? First of all they need to close the books of accounts, means they need to close the all the accounts of assets, they need to close the all types of liabilities, and after closing the books of accounts they need to pay the liabilities. How? After realization of assets, means by selling the assets. After realization of assets. And thus in this way accounts are settled, and we can say that dissolution process completed. In this way dissolution of partnership firm happens. This is about dissolution of partnership firm. Now second part is dissolution of partnership. In case of dissolution of partnership, business continues, only partnership, nature of partnership changes. When partnership does not comes to an end, partnership firm does not comes to an end. When partnership firm does not comes to an end, only old partnership comes to an end, and new partnership takes place, and new partnership takes place. Only old partnership comes to an end, business continues, old partnership comes to an end. Why old partnership comes to an end? Due to retirement or death or insolvency of any partner brings old partnership comes to an end due to retirement or death or insolvency of partner, the nature of partnership changes. Nature of partnership changes. Here, nature of partnership changes means old partnership comes to an end, and instead of old partnership, remaining partners comes into a new agreement. They enter into a new contract. That's why we have written here that new partnership take place. But business remains continuous. Business keeps continues. This is called dissolution of partnership, not firm partnership. So in case of dissolution of partnership, business keeps continues, only old partnership comes to an end, and in place of old partnership, new partnership takes place. So books of accounts remain open, business keeps continues, and such means old partnership comes to an end, happens due to retirement or death or insolvency of any partner. So whenever any partner retire from the existing firm, or any partner dies, or any partner become insolvent or incapable, in that case old partnership comes to an end, and in place of that new partnership take place. That is called dissolution of partnership, but business keeps continues. So this is the basic difference between dissolution of partnership firm and dissolution of partnership. In dissolution of partnership firm, dissolution of partnership, once again, in case of dissolution of partnership firm, dissolution of partnership automatically comes to an end. Now, differences between dissolution of partnership firm and partnership is also given in separate way in your textbook. That is on page number 276. Page number 276. Now, what is the difference between dissolution of partnership firm and dissolution of partnership? First of all, dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. Now, first difference is given in your textbook. Reorganization of partnership means dissolution of partnership. Whereas dissolution of partnership firm, permanent end of partnership firm is called dissolution of partnership firm. Now, first difference is completed. Now, reorganization of partnership is called dissolution of partnership. Now, what is the meaning of reorganization? So whenever any one partner or partners retire or dies or insolvent or incapable of doing their existing work, in that case remaining partners needs to enter into a new contract. They need to enter into a new agreement. That new contract, entering into new contract or entering into new agreement, is called reorganization of partnership. which means dissolution of partnership. Dissolution of partnership means dissolution of old partnership. Old partnership comes to an end. Now, in case of dissolution of partnership firm, permanent end of partnership firm means business is totally closed down due to dissolution of partnership firm. Means dissolution of partnership firm means dissolution of partnership as well as business. So permanent end of partnership firm, it means business is totally closed down in case of dissolution of partnership firm. Now, second difference, the existence of firm remains continuous. The existence of firm remains continuous. Means there is no effect on the existence of business partnership firm. Here there is end of existence of firm. A simple explanation is given. Existence of part firm remains continuous, means in case of dissolution of partnership, partners needs to enter into a new agreement, but business keeps continuous. There is no effect on closing of business. Business will not close down. Business remains continuous. But in case of dissolution of partnership firm, there is end of existence of firm, means business is totally closed down, shut down. Third point for difference, books of accounts remains continuous. Here books of accounts are closed. When existence of firm remains continuous, means business is not closed down, so books of accounts also remains continuous, they remain open. Whereas in case of permanent end of partnership firm, there is end of existence of firm, that's why all books of accounts, all types of accounts are closed down. Fourth is no accounts are settled. No accounts are settled. Here accounts are settled. No accounts are settled means there is no need to close down all the accounts of assets, accounts of all types of assets, accounts of or books of all types of liabilities. There is no need to close all these books. But in case of permanent end of partnership firm, there is need to close down all types of accounts, all types of ledgers, whether it is related with assets or it is liability or any other provisions. All types of accounts needs to be settled. Settled here means liabilities, after closing the accounts of liabilities, it needs to pay off. After closing the accounts of assets, it needs to sell and then recover some amount to pay the liabilities. In this way, accounts are settled in case of dissolution of partnership firm. Fifth, in case of dissolution of partnership, it is a voluntary partnership. It is a voluntary dissolution of partnership. Voluntary dissolution of partnership means it is a voluntary dissolution of partnership means no interference of court. No interference of court. Whenever existing partners want to bring some changes in their partnership, so by entering into a new contract, they can enter or they can change the nature of partnership. For example, if they want to change the profit sharing ratio, if any partner retires, when any partner admits, so they need to change the partnership, nature of partnership. So right now we are talking about dissolution. So it is a voluntary dissolution of partnership means they can close down the old partnership and enter into a new partnership. And why it happens? Due to retirement, death, insolvency or incapability of any partner, old partnership comes to an end, and instead of that, in place of that, new partnership takes place. So there is no interference of court in such type of changes. Whereas in case of dissolution of partnership firm, whenever required, court interferes. Whenever required, court interferes means dissolution of partnership firm may take place in two conditions, either without the interference of court, or sometimes court may also interfere for dissolution of partnership firm. So there is no interference of court in case of dissolution of partnership, but in case of dissolution of partnership firm, sometimes in some circumstances court may also interfere. Sixth, dissolution of firm may not take place due to dissolution of partnership, whereas dissolution of firm means dissolution of partnership also. So these are the basic difference between dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. Last point is, dissolution of partnership may not take place or may not be resulted for dissolution of partnership firm. Dissolution of firm may not take place due to dissolution of partnership means, if partnership dissolved, it does not mean that partnership firm is dissolved. If partnership dissolved means old partnership comes to an end, in place of that new partnership take place, it does not mean that it is the end of the existence of whole partnership firm. So dissolution of partnership does not mean the dissolution of partnership firm, but dissolution of partnership firm means dissolution of partnership also. So these are the basic differences between dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. Once again, reorganization of partnership is called dissolution of partnership. Here reorganization means old partnership comes to an end and new partnership takes place. And old partnership comes to an end due to retirement, death, insolvency, incapability of any partner. Due to that, old partnership comes to an end, and in place of that, new partnership take place by entering into a new contract. Whereas dissolution of partnership firm, permanent end of partnership firm, means business is totally closed down. That is called dissolution of partnership firm. Second, the existence of firm remains continuous. It means business keeps continuous. In this case, only partnership, nature of partnership changes, but business remains same. In case of dissolution of partnership firm, there is an end of existence of firm. There is an end of existence of firm, means whole business is closed down. Here, business remains continuous, business is not closed down. That's why all books of accounts remains continuous, they remains open. Whereas in case of dissolution of partnership firm, whole business closed down. That's why there is need to close the books of accounts also. Books of accounts are closed. Fourth, no accounts are settled. Means after closing the books of accounts, there is no need to sell the assets. There is no need to pay the liabilities in this case, because here only business continues. Only nature of partnership changes. That's why there is no need to immediately. There is no need to sell the assets and no need to pay the liabilities. So no accounts are settled. Here, in case of dissolution of partnership firm, business is totally closed down. That's why it becomes compulsory for partnership firm to sell all the assets and pay the liabilities. That is called settlement of account. After selling all the assets, whatever money, whatever amount is realized, out of that amount, liabilities are required to be paid. In this way, we can say that they are settling the accounts. So accounts are settled in case of dissolution of partnership firm. Next, fifth point, it is a voluntary dissolution of partnership. Means whenever any partner retires or dies or incapable of doing the work, they can enter into a new contract. They can enter into a new agreement. So there is no need to interference of court. Interference of court is not required. In case of changes the nature of partnership, if any partner wants to retire, he can retire by giving a prior notice and then remaining partners can enter into a new contract. So there is no interference of court. But in case of dissolution of partnership firm can be dissolved in two ways. First, on the mutual agreement of partners, means without interference of court. And second, in some circumstances, court may also interfere for the dissolution of whole partnership firm. And last point, dissolution of firm. Dissolution of firm means dissolution of partnership firm may not take place due to dissolution of partnership. In simple language, if partnership dissolved, it does not mean the dissolution of partnership firm. But if partnership firm dissolved, it means partnership is also dissolved. If partnership firm dissolved, automatically the partnership dissolution of partnership also take place. So dissolution of firm means dissolution of partnership also. These are the basic differences between dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. Once again, partnership means the relation between partners. The relation between partners and group of all partners is called partnership firm. Now, next topic is methods of dissolution. Methods of dissolution. Methods of dissolution. One is normal dissolution. Normal dissolution. And another is normal dissolution is also known as without interference of court. Without interference of court or voluntary dissolution. Voluntary dissolution. And second one is by the order of the court. By the order of court means firm may dissolve either without the interference of court, means partners with mutual agreement can bring comes to an end of the partnership firm, or sometimes court may interfere for the dissolution of partnership firm. So by the order of interference, there are two types of methods of dissolution. Now, first, normal distribution or voluntary dissolution or without interference of court. In which circumstances firm may dissolve without the interference of court? The first point, when all the partners agree to dissolve the firm. First point, when all the partners agree to dissolve the firm with mutual consent, means they can, when all the partners agree to dissolve the firm with mutual consent, with mutual agreement, then they can dissolve the firm. This is called voluntary partnership. One condition. Second one is when partnership firm comes to an end on the basis of predetermined contract. When partnership firm comes to an end on the basis of predetermined contract. If earlier, at the time of starting of partnership firm, if any contract they had made, and according to that contract, if partnership comes to an end, then there is no interference of court. There is no need to interfere the court in the dissolution of partnership firm. So when partnership firm comes to an end on the basis of predetermined contract. Third condition, when all the partners become insolvent or except one, all partners become insolvent. When all the partners, suppose there are four parties in a partnership firm, A, B, C, D, all partners become insolvent. Insolvent is the position when partners are not able to pay the liabilities after selling the assets of the business as well as from their personal property. If they do not have sufficient fund to pay the liability, then we can say that partners become insolvent. So if all the partners become solvent, all the four partners in our example, they become insolvent. So what happens? Dissolution of partnership firm take place, or except one, means suppose A does not become insolvent, but all the three partners B, C, D, they become insolvent. B, C, D becomes insolvent. Then partnership does not remain partnership, means only A is the owner who is solvent. So it becomes automatically, partnership is converted into sole proprietorship. So partnership does not remain. The existence of partnership automatically comes to an end. Partnership is converted into sole proprietorship. That's why it is written here, when all the partners become insolvent or except one, other partners become insolvent, in that case dissolution of partnership firm takes place. Fourth point, if partnership is constituted for a fixed term, then after the expiry of that term, partnership comes to an end. Partnership comes to an end. If partnership is started and it is for a fixed term period, for example, partnership is constituted for 10 years. So after the completion of that 10 years, automatically partnership comes to an end. In this situation, there is no need of interference of court. So automatically partnership comes to an end after the expiry of that term which was mentioned in the partnership deed. So if partnership is constituted for a fixed term, in that case, after the expiry of that term, that time period, partnership automatically comes to an end. Partnership means partnership form, automatically comes to an end. Next point, point number fifth, if partnership form is constituted for some specific purpose, then on completion or on completion of such a specific purpose, partnership comes to an end. Partnership form comes to an end. So if partnership form is constituted for some specific purpose or for achieving some specific purpose, they have targeted some aim, then on achieving that aim, on achieving that target, or on achieving that specific purpose, on fulfilling of those specific purpose, partnership form comes to an end. So these are the situation in which partnership comes to an end with the mutual agreement of all partners. In all the situation, interference of court is not required. Now second part is by the order of court. Means what are the circumstances in which court may interfere for the dissolution of partnership form. So all these points means when court may interfere, almost all points you have done in 11th standard also. First point, this is about dissolution of partnership by the court. Dissolution of a partnership by the court. First point, when any partner becomes of unsound mind, means becomes lunatic, means when his status of mind changes, becomes mad, that is called lunatic. So whenever any partner becomes of unsound mind, in that case court may interfere to dissolve the partnership form. When any partner becomes of unsound mind or when any partner becomes of lunatic position. Second point, when a partner becomes permanently incapable of performing his duties, as a partner. So whenever court feels that if any partner becomes permanently incapable, maybe due to mental disturbance means same unsound mind, mental disturbance. And second one is physical. When he becomes physically incapable to do his work as a partner, in that case also court may give order to dissolve the partnership firm. So whenever a partner becomes permanently incapable of performing his duties as a partner. Third point, when a partner undertakes misconduct against partnership firm or against business of firm. So if any partner undertakes any kind of misconduct, for example his behavior is not as per the code of conduct, if he or she is continuously tampering the accounts, means misappropriation of accounts, so in that case court may interfere and give order to dissolve the partnership firm. So 3 points: whenever any partner becomes of unsound mind, when a partner becomes permanently incapable of performing his duties as a partner. Third point is when a partner undertakes misconduct against partnership firm or against business of firm. Both are same, against partnership firm or against business of firm. Fourth point, when a partner willfully breaches the partnership agreement, means whatever terms and conditions are mentioned in the partnership agreement, partnership deed, if any partner is not following those condition of partnership deed, it is called breaches of a partnership agreement, breaches or violation of partnership agreement. If such violation is done by any partner, in that case also court may give instruction or order to close down the business. When a partner willfully violate the partnership agreement, breaches the partnership agreement. Fifth, when any partner transfer his ownership to some other person without the consent of other partner, whenever any partner, because partners cannot transfer their interest, their ownership in favor of any other person. They can do, but with the mutual consent of other partners. If other partners agrees, then they can transfer their ownership in favor of any other person. But same activities, if they have done without the consent of other partners, and this point comes into the notice of court, then court may give order to dissolve the firm. So when any partner transfer his ownership or transfer his interest in the business to some other person, in favor of some other person, without the consent of other partners, in that condition, in that situation, court may give orders to dissolve the partnership firm. Sixth, when a firm continuously incur losses. And they are unable to run the business. If any firm is facing losses continuously and they are not in a position to run the business smoothly, or they are not in a position to convert, to recover that loss, to convert that loss into a big profit, in that case also court may give order to dissolve the firm. When a firm continuously incur losses and they are unable to run the business, means they are not in a position to recover that loss, they are not in a position to convert that loss into a profit, in these situations court may give order to dissolve the firm. And last, seventh point, whenever court finds any other grounds here means reason, to be just and equitable means on the basis of just and equitable grounds, court may give order to dissolve the firm for the dissolution of firm. So these are the reasons or conditions in which court may give order to dissolve the firm. First, when any partner becomes of unsound mind, when any partner becomes permanently incapable of performing his duties as a partner, when any partner undertakes misconduct against partnership firm or against business of the firm. Fourth point, whenever any partner willfully breaches the partnership agreement, means they violate terms and conditions which are mentioned in the partnership. When any partner transfers his interest or ownership in favor of other person without the consent of other partners, or if when a firm continuously facing losses, they are not in a position to run the business smoothly, in that case, another point, whenever court finds any other reason to be just and equitable. For example, if proper management, business is not undertaken with proper management, there is mismanagement in the business, in that case also, that is called just and equitable. Or any other reason in which court feels it is better to close down the business, in that case, they can give direct order to close down the business. So these are the reasons for dissolution of partnership firm by the order of court. These are the circumstances. Once again, whenever any partner becomes unsound mind, means becomes lunatic. Second, if any partner becomes permanently incapable of performing his duties as a partner. Third point, when a partner undertakes misconduct against partnership, misconduct is of various types, his behavior is not up to the code of conduct, or he is tampering the books of accounts continuously in spite of many instructions by other partners. Whenever his activities are considered as misconduct against the partnership firm, in that case, court may give order to dissolve the partnership firm. Whenever any partner willfully violate the partnership agreement, means violate the terms and condition of partnership agreement, in that case also, court may give order to dissolve the partnership firm. Or next point, whenever any partner transfer his interest or transfer his ownership as a partner in favor of other partner without the consent of other partners, then the court may give direct order to dissolve the firm. Whenever any firm facing the loss continuously and they are not able to run the business in future, or they are not able to recover those losses, they are not able to convert those losses into a profit one, in that case also court may give order to dissolve the firm. Besides this, whenever court finds any reason to be just and equitable means whenever they feel it is better to close down the business by giving them prior notice, they can give order to close down the business. So these are the reasons for dissolution of partnership by the court. So methods of dissolution we have completed. One, voluntary dissolution means without the interference of court. That is also known as a normal distribution. Second is a dissolution of partnership firm by the order of court. So there are two modes of dissolution. One more question. What are the two modes of dissolution or two methods of dissolution? So there are two methods of dissolutions are, one is normal dissolution means without the interference of court, and second with the interference of court. And what are the circumstances we have done in case of normal dissolution and in case of interference of court? Now next topic is provisions regarding dissolution of partnership firm. What are the provisions related with dissolution of partnership firm? Provisions for accounting settlement of dissolution. Provision of accounting settlement of dissolution, that is also given on page number 277. Now regarding this first point, loss of firm. If any loss occurred to firm, then what are the provisions regarding this? First point, loss will be written off from the profit of the firm. If any loss occurs to business unit, such loss will be compensated or recovered or written off out of the profit of the business unit. But if profit is insufficient to return off that loss, then capital partners has to recover that loss out of their capital. Third point, if their capital remains insufficient then they need to dispose their personal assets. They need to dispose their personal property or personal assets in their profit loss sharing ratio. So simple points are there. Three points are there regarding loss of firm. So whenever any loss occurred to firm, first of all, such loss will be compensated, recovered or written off out of the profit of the firm. If profit of the firm is insufficient to write off the loss in that case partners needs to recover that loss, needs to compensate that loss out of their capital, means their capital reduces. As a result, their capital reduces, means such if partners are bearing that loss, why they are bearing? Because profit is insufficient. In that case, such entry will be passed on the debit side of capital account. So partners' capital reduces. But if their capital is also becomes insufficient to write off that loss, in this case they need to dispose their personal property in their profit sharing ratio, profit loss sharing ratio, in order to write off that loss. Why they need to dispose their personal property? Because we know the liability of partner is unlimited. The liability of partner is unlimited. Whenever they are not in a position to pay any loss, to compensate any loss or to pay any liability out of the business assets, in that case they need to dispose their, sell their personal property and compensate the loss. So these are the three important points related with loss of firm. Loss of firm is completed. Once again, you can see loss is always written off out of the profit of the firm. If profit of the firm, once again, if profit of the firm is insufficient, then partners needs to compensate the loss out of their capital. As a result, their capital reduces. And third point, if their capital is insufficient, then they need to dispose their personal property in their profit loss sharing ratio to write off the loss. Reason is their capital is, the nature of their capital is unlimited. The first provision for accounting settlement of dissolution is completed. Second point, liability of firm and personal liabilities of partners. Almost same explanation which you have done in first point. Topic is liabilities of firm. Liabilities of firm and personal liabilities of partner. Now we know the liability of partner is unlimited. Unlimited. Now the liability is unlimited means liabilities of firm and personal liabilities of partners. First of all, liabilities of partner firm is always paid out of the profit earned by the business unit, or liabilities of firm is paid out of the property of assets. Whenever a liability incurs, it will be paid out of profit, or if profit is not sufficient, then business units needs to sell the property of business, assets of business, then they need to pay the liabilities. But if business assets are insufficient to pay the liabilities of firm, in that case they need to dispose of their personal property in order to pay the liability, because their capital is, or their liability, sorry, their liability is unlimited. That's why if business property, business assets are insufficient to pay the debt, to pay the debt or to pay the liabilities of firm, then they need to dispose of their personal property also. In this regard, another point is, before explaining this another point, we are assuming that total there are four partners A, B, C and D. Four partners are there. Now suppose if one partner become insolvent, so if any one partner or partners, if any partner or partners become insolvent. If any partner or partners become insolvent means either one or two partners become insolvent, it means they are not in a position to, they do not have personal property also to pay the liability. If any partner or partners become insolvent, in that case, other partners has to take the responsibility to pay the liabilities. Other solvent partners has to take the responsibility to pay the liabilities. This is another point. First of all, topic is liabilities of firm and personal liabilities of partners. Whenever any liability arises in business, any loss incurred in business, first of all, partners needs to pay those liabilities, pays those loss, to recover those loss out of the profit earned by them. If such profit is insufficient, then they need to pay such liabilities out of the business property. Means by selling the property, they need to pay the liabilities. If business property is also insufficient to pay the liabilities, to pay the debt, then they need to dispose of their personal property. Reason, their liability is unlimited. Second point is, if any partner or partners become insolvent, for example, there are four partners in a partnership firm, A, B, C and D, and assume that D is insolvent or C is also insolvent, two partners are insolvent. Means they are not in a position to dispose of their personal property. They do not have any personal property so that they can sell those property and pay the liabilities. So they are not in a position. They are insolvent. C and D are insolvent. In that case, other solvent partners, means A and B, has to compensate, has to take the responsibility to pay all the liabilities. Means they have to take the responsibility of C and D also. They have to distribute the liability which should be paid by C and D in their profit loss sharing ratio. So this is another point. Another topic is partners loan to the firm. We will discuss later on. Next one is loan of partner's wife. Now, if partner's wife has given any loan to the firm, so how will we treat that loan in our accounting treatment? The first point, if wife has given loan, to the firm out of his personal property. Personal property means property which are in her name. Out of that personal property, if she has given loan to the firm, then such loan will be treated as third party liability. Third party liability. If wife of any partner has given loan to the firm out of her personal property, then such loan will be treated as third party liability. Once again, if wife of any partner has given loan to the firm out of her personal property, then such liability will be treated as third party liability. Now, what we have to do with third party liability, we will discuss later on. But right now, you have to keep in mind that such loan will be considered as third party liability. Second point, if wife has given loan is given by wife of any partner. if wife has given loan, wife means here wife of any partner has given loan to the firm, to the firm, wife of any partner. If wife of any partner has given loan to the firm, but out of husband's property, husband's property, then such loan will be treated as partner's loan. Partner's loan. And how partner's loan will be treated in the accounting treatment at the time of dissolution of partnership firm, we will discuss later on. But right now, you have to keep these two points in your mind. If wife has given loan to the firm, wife of any partner has given loan to the firm out of her personal property, then such loan will be considered as third party liability, means external liability, means external liability, outside liability, external liability. But if wife of any partner has given loan out of the property of his husband, then such loan will be taken as partner's loan, not third party liability. It will be treated as partner's loan. Now, how would we deal with these two items, third party liability, what we have to do when it is third party liability, what we have to do, what we have to give accounting treatment if it is partner's loan, we will discuss later on. Right now, theoretical portion. Whenever loan is given by wife of any partner out of her personal property, it will be treated as third party liability or external liability or outside liabilities. But if such loan is given by, means wife has given loan out of husband's property, then such loan will be taken as partner's loan. Next topic. Next topic is settlement of accounts. Settlement of accounts at the time of dissolution of firm. Dissolution of firm means how all the expenses, all types of liabilities are paid, all types of liabilities are paid, in which order. So first of all, first point, first of all, dissolution expense, first of all, dissolution expense is to be paid second. After paying dissolution expense, now what is dissolution expense, after some moment I will explain, but first of all, dissolution expense is to be paid, then third party liabilities are required to pay, required to pay. Third point, partner's loan, if any, will be paid. Partner's loan, if any, will be paid. Fourth, credit balance of capital, partner's capital or current account will be paid. And fifth, if any surplus available, then such surplus will be distributed between or among partners in their profit loss sharing ratio. Now this is about settlement of accounts. When partnership comes to an end, means dissolution of partnership form takes place, then what we have to do, what is the procedure? First of all they need to close the accounts means close the accounts of assets, close the accounts of all types of liabilities. Then after closing the accounts, they need to sell all the assets in order to receive cash. That is called realization of assets, means asset is sold and cash is received. That is called realization of assets. Once assets are realized, so out of that realized amount, all types of liabilities are paid. This is the procedure of dissolution of partnership form. So first of all, assets are closed, all accounts are closed, then assets are sold out, then out of that realized amount, liabilities are paid. But in which order expenses or liabilities are paid? So first of all, dissolution expense is to be paid. Now what is dissolution expense? Any expense which incurred at the time of procedure of dissolution of partnership firm, such expense is called dissolution expense. And such expense starts right from the procedure of dissolution of partnership firm. For example, suppose firm has debtors. Debtors means customers from whom we have to receive amount in future. We have decided to receive amount in future. These customers are called debtors. For example, there are various customers X, Y, Z, W, and all customers are residing at distant places. So at the time of dissolution, now our business comes to an end. So we have to receive our money from these different customers, means from these different debtors. So in order to approach them to recover the amount, we have to use bike or a scooty, and for this purpose we need petrol expense to refill the bike or a scooty. We need petrol. So in order to approach those customers, we have to incur petrol expense. That petrol expense is called dissolution expense. Another example, in order to sell fixed assets immediately within a very short span of time, we take the help of various intermediaries, brokers. So to those brokers we are paying some commission in advance, so that they will motivate to sell all the assets immediately. That type of expense is called dissolution expense. So any expense which starts incurring right from the procedure of dissolution of partnership form, such expense is called dissolution expense. So first of all, out of the amount available or out of the amount which we receive from selling of assets, we need to do dissolution expense. Second, third party liabilities or external liabilities, creditor, bill payable, bank overdraft, bank loan, outstanding expense if any, such expenses are called third party liability or external liabilities. So out of the amount which we have received by selling the assets, after selling the assets, whatever amount is available, first of all dissolution expense, then we have to pay third party liabilities. We have to pay liabilities towards creditors, liabilities towards bill payable, any bank loan, then bank overdraft, short term loan, outstanding expense if any, such expenses, such liabilities are required to pay. After paying those liabilities, means after paying third party liabilities, then whatever balance is left, out of that balance of amount, partner, if any partner has given loan to the firm, suppose four partners are there, ABCD, A has given loan of 40,000 rupees to the firm. So at the time of dissolution, at the time of closing of business, after paying amount to third party, his loan will be repaid. His loan will be repaid from where? From the selling of assets, whatever money we have received. First of all assets are sold. All assets are sold or disposed. Sold or disposed. Then whatever amount available with the firm, with that amount, first of all, dissolution expense is to be paid, then external liabilities is to be paid. Then if any partner has given loan to the firm, such loan will be repaid. After paying partner's loan, then credit balance of capital or current account will be paid. Whatever balance, means according to capital account, according to current account, if any credit balance of partners is there, in simple language you can say, whatever amount invested by partners into the business, such amount will be returned to those partners. And which balance? Balance comes according to capital account, credit balance, or credit balance of current account. So they need to prepare capital account, they need to prepare current account. Whatever balance comes on the credit side, such balance will be repaid out of that amount. After paying balance of capital or current account of partners, then also if any surplus is available, is left, then such surplus will be distributed between or among all these partners in their profit loss sharing ratio. And hence accounts settled. In this way they have to settled. In this way they have to distribute the amount or distribute the cash after cash available with the firm after selling all the assets. First of all, dissolution expense is to be paid. After paying dissolution expense, third party liability is to be paid. Then after that, if any partner has given loan to the firm, such loan is repaid. Then balance of capital or current account is to be returned to the partners. And then also if any surplus is available, after returning all the amount to partners on the basis of their capital account or current account, then also if any surplus is left, then such surplus will be distributed between or among partners in their profit loss sharing ratio. In this way, the amount available by selling the assets will be repaid. An account is settled. Now, which types of accounts we are doing? Dissolution of partnership firm. In dissolution of partnership firm, which types of accounts are prepared? So preparation of account in case of dissolution of partnership firm. Accounts prepared at the time of dissolution. Accounts prepared at the time of dissolution. Which accounts are prepared? First of all, realization account. Realization account is also known as, that it is not given in your textbook, it is also known as accomplishment account. Second account is partners loan account. If any partner has given loan to the firm, in that case partners loan account is needs to prepare. Third, partners capital or current account is prepared. And last, cash or bank account is prepared. These are the four types of accounts which needs to prepare in case of dissolution of partnership firm. First of all, realization account or accomplishment account. What is relation account? What is accomplishment account? We will discuss later on. First of all, try to understand which types of accounts we need to prepare at the time of dissolution of partnership firm. Realization account or accomplishment account. Second, partner's loan account. If any partner has given loan to the firm, then we need to prepare partner's loan account. Then, partner's capital account or current account. And fourth, last one is cash or bank account. In this chapter, we are not required to prepare balance sheet. Reason, in case of dissolution of partnership firm, all assets are sold out. Means we do not have any assets. And after selling all the assets, out of the realized amount, out of the recovered amount, we pay all the liabilities. It means liabilities also does not remain in the business. So there is no liability, there is no assets, there is no need to prepare balance sheet. We need to prepare cash or bank account. So there are four types of accounts which are prepared at the time of dissolution. So till here we have completed almost all important theory portion, and remaining short questions based on practical we will discuss later on. So far as theory, important theory portion we have completed. What is a dissolution? End of existence either of partnership firm or of partnership is called dissolution of partnership firm or dissolution of partnership. Now what is the difference between dissolution of partnership firm and dissolution of partnership we have done. Next topic, we have completed modes of dissolution, means in which circumstances firm may dissolve. So there are two methods, normal dissolution means without the interference of court, and in which circumstances partners may dissolve the firm we have done. There are different methods, willfully means by giving prior notice to all partners they can dissolve the firms, or if a partnership is for a particular time period, then after completion of time period they can dissolve the partnership firm. If they have started partnership for achieving some specific purpose, then after completion or fulfilling of such a specific purpose, partnership comes to an end. So in all these circumstances there is no interference of court. Then with the interference of court we have done, means by the order of court firm may dissolve when any partner is of unsound mind, when they willfully misconduct or breaches the agreement, partnership agreement. In that case also, or if any partner misconduct. Third, when firm is incurring losses continuously, or when court feels just and equitable, means on the basis of just and equitable reasons, court may give order to dissolve the firm. Then we have done settlement of accounts, means in which order expenses or liabilities are paid after selling the assets. So after selling all the assets, whatever amount is realized, first of all dissolution expense is to be paid, then third party liability is paid, then after that partner's loan is to be paid, then after that credit balance of capital and current accounts is to be paid, then also if any surplus is left, then that surplus will be distributed between or among partners in their profit loss sharing ratio. Beside this, we have done provisions regarding dissolution of partnership firm, in which we have done loss of firm. So loss, if any loss incurred to the firm, such loss will be paid out of profit. If a profit is insufficient, then partners needs to pay, compensate that loss out of their capital, means their capital reduces. And if their capital is insufficient, then they need to sell their personal property in order to compensate the loss. Similarly, same liability of partnership firm. This loss of firm, second one is liabilities of partnership firm. So if any liability arises at the time of dissolution, first of all, such liabilities will be paid out of realized amount. Realized amount means after selling the assets, whatever amount realized, out of that realized amount such liabilities will be paid at the time of dissolution. If such amount is insufficient to pay the liabilities, then partners have to pay such liabilities out of their, means out of their capital. Then also if amount is insufficient, liabilities remains there, then they need to pay the personal property because their liability is unlimited. So after selling the assets, then also they are not in a position to pay the liability. After selling the assets of the business, they are not in a position to pay the liability, then they need to pay the personal, sell the personal property and pay the liabilities. Among all the partners, another point, among all the partners, if any partner or partners are insolvent, then the part of their responsibility will be borne by other solvent partner, other solvent partner. I have already told you four partners are there. If two partner or one partner become insolvent, means they are not in a position to pay, sell their personal property, they do not have any personal property, or their personal property becomes insufficient to pay the liability, then their responsibility to pay the liability is to be taken or borne by a remaining solvent partner. Next topic is wife's loan. Wife's loan. If any partner's wife has given loan to the firm, so we have to, first of all, we have to see that whether she has given loan out of her personal property or out of her husband's property. If she has given loan out of her personal property, then such loan will be taken as third party liability, means external liability. And if she has given loan out of husband's property, then such loan will be taken as partner's loan, not third party liability, partner's loan. Last topic, which types of accounts are prepared at the time of dissolution? Realization account or accomplishment account. Second one is partner's loan account, if partner's loan is given in the question then. Third, partner's capital or current account. And last one is cash or bank account. So these are the important theory related with practical questions. After that, we will start relation account, how relation account is prepared. Till then, goodbye.